What is going on, everybody? It is Mike. Welcome back to Tech247 TV. I am so excited to have you back here. I've gotten a lot of comments based on my previous video where I unboxed and talked about the M1 Mac Mini. This is Apple's system on a chip that integrates CPU, GPU, hardware controllers, T2 security chip, and unified memory into a single device. Now, in today's video, we're gonna do some testing around Final Cut and how this machine performs using Final Cut and answer the age-old question that I'm sure everyone watching this video has: can I use this thing to edit video? Which is really kind of a valid question because it's got attractive price point. In terms of performance, it's actually kind of performing better than my more expensive MacBook Pro. And we're gonna get an understanding of how this machine is gonna perform in today's video. Let's get started. As I mentioned in the beginning, my name is Mike. This is Tech247 TV. Here we unbox and do product reviews of all the newest technology. So if you are new to the channel, make sure you click subscribe so you can be alerted when new content drops. Everything that you see here on my A-roll is recorded with a Sony A7 III with a 24mm G Master. This is gonna be recorded on an external recorder using the Atomos Ninja 5. Now, in terms of the type of tests, I'm gonna import the footage. I'm gonna go ahead and create optimized media. I'll create proxy media, delete that media, and then I'll also go ahead and apply color correction, LUTs, and motion graphics. Now, the problem with some of these videos that I have here as an example, these are gonna have existing color correction and LUTs applied to them where the developer of those has not updated them. So I've completely turned them off in the instances where I can. Some of them, like these transitions, I can't turn them off because they're just not updated at all. I can remove them, but that wouldn't necessarily do anything because it's not like the footage doesn't play. It just plays some default clip. So you're seeing here, let's make sure we're gonna go ahead and take all of these clips here. It looks like there's definitely some lockup happening, but we'll give it a moment. This project is 85 gigs in terms of a project. And the master file, when it outputs, is in the neighborhood of 46 gigs. So it's absolutely not a small project. And I'd love to know what size projects that you guys are working on in terms of how this relates to what you do. So that was just some kind of brief hiccup, it looks like. Now I'm gonna go here, I'm gonna go to delete generated media files. Let's pull up the RAM. So here, RAM, we're using 1.9 gigs of RAM. Let's go file, delete deleted files, delete optimized, and delete any kind of proxy files. Let's click OK. And so if I go to the project level here at the very top, I see that there are 83 gigs, nothing in optimized, nothing in proxy files. So this is on the machine here. So now here, I'm gonna go ahead and click on file, master file, and this is gonna go ahead and create a master file in ProRes 422 from this project. I'm gonna click on settings, we're gonna do audio and video. We see here the resolution is 3840 by 1920, that's 2:1 aspect ratio, that's how I render my videos. Compressor is gonna be the next action, and we have all the video and audio roles, including the motion graphics. So I'm just gonna say this render test one. Let me make sure I have my phone so we can go ahead and time this. All right, so we have zero as the time. We're gonna click on next. We're gonna do render test one, and this is gonna be going to my internal drive, and we're gonna click start, and we click start. The few times that I did this, I was running screen recording on my Mac and it was a dog. Like it took like 10 minutes to go ahead and export this file. So I would tell you that if you are trying to validate the functionality that I'm going through right now and you're gonna export files, you certainly don't run screen recording because that is gonna slow down your Mac unbelievably. We're at 94%, 3 minutes and 21 seconds. So 3 minutes and 21 seconds to get this master file. Now let's go ahead and throw, we're gonna convert this or transcode this to HEVC. And let's take a look here with how that performs. Now I don't need to measure this or time this because Compressor, which is a built-in, or this is a professional app from Apple, it has a timer built in there automatically, which if you're not using Compressor, I would say it's definitely something that I would consider adding to my workflow. For 50 bucks, you are able to export multiple formats from a single batch. And it really, I think it just helps with, in my opinion, the quality of the video, because first you output a master, and then from that master, you output to these other non-master formats such as HEVC or MPEG-4, whatever the case is, depending on where you're outputting it for. This is still completely scrubbable, right? I'm doing nothing. I'm playing it. It's all coming here. There's nothing, no delay. It just plays effortlessly. Even when these titles aren't working and you got to turn them off, it's pretty freaking smooth. Very impressive. I think that the application of this, if you are someone who has, if you obviously live in the Final Cut ecosystem right now, it is very good for you. Now, this is obviously a kind of very narrow look of how this computer performs with certain types of footage, shot in certain aspect ratios, under certain conditions, and color correct a certain way. So there's very kind of, it's not broadly applicable to everyone that's watching this video. That's just how it is. But if you are shooting with a certain type of camera or you have footage that you want me to go ahead and test, please let me know in the comments below. I will go ahead and work with you to get the footage and to import it and see how it looks. That is certainly a very good use case. Now here, just going back to compressor, we're about 50% done. We're at 2 minutes and 50 seconds. So it looks like it's on track for that 6 minute mark. Now I can tell you that seriously, this project would absolutely bottleneck and probably crash my Mac, because I was getting maybe 6 or 7 crashes a day working with projects this big in the past. And this is a very common size project for me for video that I put out. I probably put out 1 or 2 videos that are this size and of kind of this scope and magnitude per week. Other videos are usually shorter and they don't have as much impact. And let's just look at performance here. So we look at the CPU performance. So it shows CPU performance is probably about 50% of the way here. Actually, it is 50%. Earlier, when I was using Final Cut, it was almost at 100%, it looks like. Compressor is using 7% of processes available. The GPU is not even pegged. It shows memory is max, but I don't know is whether or not iStat menu, which is the application I use to monitor all these different KPIs, whether or not it's been updated to take advantage of the new operating system in the M1. So that's something that's still unknown. Let's just do kind of another test. Let's do Photoshop. I'm going to open that up here on the same machine. So I have Photoshop, Final Cut, and Compressor, which is transcoding a video. So now here, I'm going to go ahead and go to this. And you see here, I am adding, you know, vibrance, turning these layers off. There's 1, 2, 3, 4. There's like 9 layers in this Photoshop document that I'm working on, which isn't necessarily a lot, but to give you an idea of how things run at this point. Let's go back. There's Final Cut. Where are you at, Compressor? Compressor is almost done. 5 minutes and 34 seconds. We're about 95% done. And you could see, again, using all three of these apps at the same exact time, it's running pretty smoothly. So I would feel confident, unless you're shooting like 8K, man, I would actually even think that to some degree 8K, if it's ProRes, you're definitely going to have, it definitely should be playable. But if you have footage and you want me to check it out, let me know in the comments below. Again, we'll work together to go ahead and get that done. Here, this is complete now. Test for render. So we finished at 6 minutes on the button. So again, first one, 3 minutes and 18 seconds. Second one, 6 minutes. That is a transcode to ProRes 422, and then a transcode to HEVC 6 minutes. So total project time under 10 minutes for 2 exports. That is pretty insane in my opinion. Let me know what you have been experiencing on your existing computer. Now I have more content planned around testing on the M1, the Mac Mini, as well as I have the MacBook Pro, which should be here Monday or Tuesday of next week, which is Thanksgiving here in the US. So let me know what kind of tests that you want me to run. And I have some additional content planned around. This is awesome. This is really great. I am Mike. This is Tech 24/7 TV. I'm so glad that you joined me today. Hope to see you in the next video.